Welcome everyone. We're gonna make a video for you guys today talking about all of the pros and maybe some of the cons of traveling with a pet.
People ask us all the time what it's like to travel, especially internationally and in a vehicle with our dog. If it's difficult, if it's complicated. It's not difficult, but it is sometimes complicated. So today we're gonna go through some of the main tips that we've learned that you can use if you're traveling with your dog to help make your experience a little bit easier, definitely happier for you and your pet.
We get asked to make this video all the time, so for all the people asking, here you go. Hopefully this satisfies all of your worries and wonders. The very first thing, which is also the absolute number one question we get about Frank, is when it's hot outside, what do you do with Frank?
So we've been in Central America where it is so hot outside, but we have a really good system in place to keep it cool in the van for the dog.
So a lot of people, when they think about leaving your dog in the car, it's referred to leaving your dog in your Honda Civic or your Toyota Tacoma or some regular vehicle with all the windows up or maybe even the windows cracked. Still can get extremely, extremely hot inside a vehicle. This is a little bit different with a van or an RV. We have a roof vent fan, which is a 14-inch opening with a fan built into it that can either push air in or suck air out. But it doesn't work by itself. If you just have a roof vent and you try to blow in or suck out and there's no other opening, there's no airflow. It will still get extremely hot. So we team it up with one of the windows. We open one of the windows all the way. So we turn the roof vent fan to 100%, as high as it can go. It moves a lot of air, which creates a wind tunnel through the van, which almost keeps the van at the same temperature as the shade outside, because there's so much fresh air moving through. There's not a lot of time for the air to heat up and become really, really hot inside the van. When we were in the States and we were working remotely on the road, we would put up the window covers, open the window, turn on the roof vent fan, and sit in our van when it was 105 degrees outside and work. Yeah. So it's not like we're putting Frank in some scenario that we don't put ourselves at or put ourselves in as well. Also, Frank would be at our feet when we're working and it's 105 degrees. It keeps it really nice inside the van with this system.
Now, that being said, if we're in here with Frank and it's 100 degrees, that's just kind of the way it is, but we're with him and we're able to monitor him. Generally, if it's over like 90, 95 degrees, we don't leave Frank in the van by himself. There are just some days where it's too hot to leave the dog alone by himself in the van. You just don't want to take that risk. And when it's over 90, 95 degrees outside, we just make sure that whatever we're doing that day includes Frank.
Absolutely.
If you've been following our latest series, we're actually traveling from the States through Mexico into Central America. We've been crossing a ton of borders, and people are always very curious what it takes to take Frank with us through all these international border crossings.
And it's really simple. You basically just need one piece of paper.
Yeah.
This piece of paper comes from your vet. There are some requirements that you need to undertake before you get the piece of paper, which is all of his vaccinations, his rabies vaccination, all of his shots need to be up to date. He needs to have been inspected by a veterinary within the last 30 days to say that he doesn't have any diseases. They will note all of this on a paper that's basically an internationally accepted bill of health.
So border crossings do tend to take a little bit more time because we have Frank with us, but it's really easy. Sometimes they want to see Frank, make sure he's healthy. Maybe they ask us when the last time he had frontline or flea and tick prevention, but that's about it. Generally, they want you to pay a small fee, 10 to 20 bucks.
In Belize, it was like 50 bucks.
It was a lot in Belize, that's right. But basically, all you need is a certificate of health and a vaccination history and a healthy dog, and you're good to go. Now, while we're down here in some of these countries, one of my main concerns for safety and health was making sure that we had access to clean drinking water. And we need to be really careful about where we get our water from because some of the water sources around here are not necessarily potable? Potable.
Contaminated.
Potable? Potable.
Potable.
Potable. Clean for drinking.
Potable.
So, this might be considered common sense, but it's just something that you have to adjust when you're outside the States and traveling in some of these other countries, is that we only give Frank water to drink that we would drink ourselves.
Mm-hmm. So no tap water, no hose water, no random water in the street. Things that are probably obviously common sense, but if it's clean enough for you, it's clean enough for them. And if it's not clean enough for you, I wouldn't give it to your dog because they can get sick just like we get sick.
Totally.
So the next thing on the list is dog food. It's not always easy to find dog food down here, or when you get out of the States, it can be kind of a pain. We've been places where we ask for dog food and they're like, here you go. And it's like, comida para perro y gato.
They got what you need?
Dog chow.
Dog chow. Is it cat chow too?
The other one was, dude.
Jordan tried to go get dog food earlier today, and they had dog food that was para perro y para gato.
It's both.
Which is
this one definitely has a dog in it.
Yep.
That's a happy doggy.
Which is like cat and dog food.
Which
like,
doesn't make any sense.
I don't want to do that. So even places where we've gone to a grocery store and they have dog food, it's usually like really low grade dog food, or it's like cornmeal based. And sometimes Frank won't even eat that dog food, which makes me think it's probably not very good for him.
That's so scary because Frank is so motivated by food and literally will eat anything, anywhere, any time of day. And then we put some dog food in front of him and he wouldn't eat it.
Yeah.
Freaked us out. We bought different dog food.
So we try really hard to get quality dog food that's, you know, the first two or three ingredients are like meat, or, you know, meat byproducts or something along those lines. Maybe we're being a little bit paranoid about this, but we just want to make sure that he's healthy. And one of the big building blocks of health is food. So we want to make sure he has good food.
People are always asking us, how did Frank adapt to living in the van? And was it an easy transition to have him traveling with us all the time? And the answer is really like, he has always kind of had this lifestyle since we got him as a puppy in the van. But honestly, we've practiced it with him for a very long time. And the more often you take your dog with you and bring him into social situations or into new places and let him explore and experience a new scenario, the more comfortable he'll be in that situation next time. So we try to bring him with us to as many places as we can so that he can learn how to handle those situations in a positive, successful way. So we always try to set him up for success. That means we keep him on a leash, we keep a pretty close eye on him, we try to make sure he's well behaved, and we definitely have to look out for other animals on every single outing.
So since we've been south of the border, or since we entered Mexico, there's been a huge increase in the number of stray dogs. There's just hundreds and hundreds or thousands of stray dogs, and everywhere you go, half or more of the dogs that you see don't have a family or don't have an owner. They roam the streets, they look for scrap food, they eat garbage. Most of them have mange or fleas or ticks or diseases. So it's very important that you don't let your dog socialize with the strays. And you can usually suss out the situation and figure out if the dog is infected with something or is sick. There's been numerous occasions where we've given food to stray dogs that look like they haven't eaten in quite a long time.
Yeah.
But at the same time, we don't let Frank play with these dogs because we don't want any communicable diseases to be transferred, even though Frank has all of his shots.
So if they look really healthy, we generally assume that they're well fed, they're being cared for, they're safe for Frank to play with.
Yeah.
If they look a little bit unhealthy, we try to keep Frank away from them, which is heartbreaking to see and one of the hardest things for us to have to deal with, but it is just thrown in our face pretty much every day. Just a reality of traveling with our dog.
So with that being said, we try not to let Frank hang out or play with these stray dogs because we're worried about him getting diseases or maybe getting fleas or ticks. And that brings us to our next tip, is that you need to get on top of the dog's personal hygiene and extra little tidbits. Obviously there's vaccinations and shots, but there's heartworm, there's flea and tick medicine, which we use Frontline, which is a substance that you put on the neck of the dog once a month, and that helps keep the fleas and the ticks away. These are things that you need to stay on top of to make sure that your dog remains healthy while you're on the road.
Especially when there's just all this different shrubbery and greenery that they're running through with ticks everywhere, I'm sure. On top of that, maybe I'm just a little bit of a clean freak. I don't know. I don't know if you would say that.
Yeah.
I like to keep it really clean in the van. And one of the ways to keep the van clean is to keep the dog clean. So I brush Frank multiple times a day. It helps get a lot of his excess fur and shedding out of the van, but it also helps check him for any ticks that he might have picked up as he was running through any of the landscapes around here. So we definitely stay on top of his vaccinations and medicine, all of his flea, tick, heartworm, parasite stuff, but we also just try to keep him clean in general. It helps him stay happier, helps the van stay cleaner.
And it helps Allie sleep at night.
It helps me sleep at night.
Now, the last tip that we have for you guys today before we let you go is probably pretty obvious. And if you already have a dog, you should know this, that an exercised dog is a happy dog.
Yeah.
If you have a van and you're living in it and you have a dog, your dog doesn't even get to run around the house.
Yeah.
He is pretty much cramped up inside your van. So if you're asking, well, what do you do with him when you go out and do activities? If you're leaving your dog in the van repetitively, he's gonna have a lot of pent up energy. And the only way to get that pent up energy out is to go out and exercise him. He runs behind the motorcycle or by our pedal bikes when we're in the States. You gotta keep them exercised, and then they're gonna be more well-behaved, yeah. They're gonna sleep better. It's one of the cornerstones also for a healthy dog.
Yeah.
So that's the last tip that we have for living in a van with your dog, is to make sure that they stay exercised.
So we love to go hiking and swimming and playing frisbee and running around, and Frank loves all of that just as much. So we try to get him out with us every single day, even if it's not for very long. As much as we can get out with him, we take advantage of every opportunity.
He definitely has more fun and gets out more than when we lived in a house.
So yeah,
take that for what you will.
Yeah. Those are kind of the few tips that we wanted to share with you about what it's like to travel with a dog in van life. It's definitely something that we would highly recommend. We have no regrets about traveling with Frank. He completes this lifestyle.
If you guys have any other tips that you think we missed, leave them in the comments, or questions you can leave in the comments as well. We want to thank you guys so much for watching this video today. Hopefully you enjoyed it. If you did, please like this video by clicking the like button. Subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. Hit the notification bell so that you guys are notified when we put out new videos.
And we'll talk to you soon, guys.
See you guys on the next one.
Bye.